Welcome everybody to Bears and Dragons. We're a bunch of nerdy ass bears sit around and play Dungeons and Dragons.
We play Dungeons and Dragons!
Thank you. So, previously, the Wayfaring Strangers, well, what were they doing?
We've been exploring more of Blindenstone.
I believe we took down our Medusa last time.
Yes.
And we continued to wander the halls of where she was, and we came across a room of many statues that are attacking us. Unjustly. I believe we were taking back the Medusa's head to also prove that we did the deed so we can get some payment and better standing to get out of here. What else am I missing? Anybody?
No, thank you.
That's pretty spot on.
That's pretty much it.
Yeah.
No.
I haven't really been too trustworthy, not very helpful in anything, so it's you're earning their trust. Slowly but surely by doing heroic deeds, I suppose. But right now you're in battle.
Go forth, Holly. Destroy.
Holly! It's Holly's turn.
Okay. We are going to do our normal Bambo Great Weapon Master Reckless Attack on this one. Guessing a 22 will hit. I'm not sure why that's not showing up.
Uh-oh. 22 does hit.
Okay. That's not what I want to hit. Oh. That is why, somehow, my Beyond 20 isn't working.
Oh no! It just turned off?
It's just, yeah, it's just off. Refresh this. There we go! That'd be 25 for the first hit.
He swings her axe down and basically cuts the statue in twain.
And then we go Bimbo Bambo over here and do the exact same thing. Because, you know, what? Let's not break something that's not... Or, I don't know English words. It's just... thing.
They're hard.
Yeah.
English actually is pretty hard for non-speaking.
13's not gonna hit, is it? Okay, swing of the mouth.
Momentum of the axe kind of got her a little off them. Right, front. But I have to... You know, I started trying to get prepared, and I not intentionally adjusted. Bring these on. We are. Front is raging. And move up to this one. Actually, over here. He doesn't have to go reckless. He'll make an attack. And he dink. Doesn't swing it hard enough. He just goes, rawr! He didn't. Lassiter!
I am going to do nothing really. I'll just blast two pick one. This one that they're working on.
Focus fire.
Crap. Not advantage. Normal roll.
18. That hits.
Twelve for the first hit.
Yep.
Oh.
Oh, attack. Did it.
Okay. Fifteen.
And
darn.
Alright. You did chip a good chunk of its head away.
Is anyone damaged?
Holly.
Nope.
Holly, Ron.
Holly?
Yeah.
If I'm able to, hold on. Pretty sure I have healing word. Yeah. I'll do a healing word at Holly.
Okay. What's the word?
I never remember a word. Bless you.
Two words technically, but we'll go with it.
Whatever.
Literally rolled the minimum amount of healing.
You're welcome. As a matter of fact, that's it. Those are my two words. You're welcome.
I mean, not too shabby.
All that's right. My turn.
It's the statue's turn. Oh, hold on. I'm using. All right. So the one right in front of Folly. Makes a couple of slam attacks. Slam! Misses. Slam! Misses.
That's it. Actually hits.
At a 9?
At a 24.
It's not at a
reckless.
Advantage. Oh.
Reckless.
Reckless. Okay.
Yeah.
So she would take 14 damage. Well, reduce to 7.
Well, technically, shouldn't it be more because it was a crit?
The crit, yeah, because the crit is 8 plus 6. It's 2
rolls. Oh, the crit is, okay.
The 2 rolls was four, total of 14.
Gotcha.
These are drow statues, right?
Well, drow statues, drow. Yes.
Yeah. Drow, whatever.
Good, different things.
Whatever.
Don't make me pull out Matt Mercer for pronunciation purposes. Unless it's a mercenary. That was two slim tests. Got it. And oh, not done. I got more. One's gonna come over to Rot. This one's gonna Molly. One's gonna come over to this weird dragon thing. This one's gonna eldest, and this one's gonna come up to. Three, four, five, six.
Ooh. Is this one still up?
Yes.
Fuck.
It just had a good chunk of rock come off of it. If you're trying to unpetrify them, they probably not gonna. Alright, so first one against Vaunt. A couple slam attacks against him. Oh, totally whiffs. Hits the other statue for four. I mean, if it was with advantage. That's a really awful book. Second slam attack against Ront. That will hit. Oh, he's raging, so that's only four. Alright. Statue for Holly. Does a couple slam attacks. You're still reckless, right? Or it was reckless, right?
Yeah, so. Still my next turn. Yep, 18? So take four. Yes, so take four.
And 21, so.
Three.
That is three. Alright, the one against the pseudo Thembertrod. A couple of slam attacks. 14.
No.
And oh, a crit. For 6 points of damage.
Six. Okay. I just gotta remember.
Hold this.
47.
Alright, so this, okay. Take 7 points of damage. And swing two. Oh, misses and hits the one next to him for. That's like the second time they rolled double crit fails. And the one on one's attacking Jim Jar. Misses with a seven and misses with the 13. Jar just dodges out of the way. And that would be the. This one. I think I missed this one, the barely alive one. No, that one already attacked. Cool. Eldest. Need a. Use this one. Compound everything. There we go. Alright. Well, takes a swing against the one that attacked her. Makes it. Got her sealed up, so. One-handed. Ooh, nice. 2 points of damage. Doom Jar gets sneak attack. If he can hit. Let's see. Got a dagger and a sword. So he's gonna. It's actually gonna attack the one that's that Eldis is attacking. Misses with his sword with his offhand attack. Misses also. A tink tink. This is really more of what it ends up happening. Doesn't have enough strength behind. Parad.
Yep. All right. Definitely. So, centered right here. Fireball! Oh, shh. Of course, I gotta refresh YouTube. Okay. Let me do this. Yeah, so, fireball!
Right.
So it's gonna be this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and then these four. Total of nine. Need a deck save and throw.
Alright, we'll start. I'll go left, right, and then down. So, starting this one. This one, etc. Needless to say, they're not very dexterous.
Nope, nope.
You're gonna be getting a little laggy. Here we go.
Nope.
Nope. Nope. Nope.
So far, a lot of statues crumbling, right? Nope.
3, 4.
Oh. That's 5. So 4 more. Nope.
Definite. Nope.
Nope. Yes.
Ooh, we got one. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Lost track. So. Second to last one only takes 22. Everyone else dies.
So 44 points of damage, so that.
Fireballs are addressed to whom it may concern.
Sadly. Fire is not one of the damage immunities.
Either way, it has to be full-blown immunity. Even if it's resistance, it gets past it, because I have fire, elemental depth fire. Oh, has to be full-blown immunity.
I mean, one of them just explodes into dust as part of this. Well, the rest kind of like just break and crumble. There's a few large chunks, but a few smaller chunks.
And then I'm going to quicken cast. Use the last 2 points of my sorcery points to quicken cast a firebolt to this motherfucker who didn't die. Because I'm insulted.
Do this guy?
Yeah.
All right, 27 hits. Slams right into it, and it falls apart.
I was insulted. The audacity he had to still stand after that, so I was just like, nope. And then... Okay. Thimbercharge's turn. Or Fake Charge's turn. So... We're gonna step, have him. Well, first we're gonna do a rend attack on this one, Eldith. Let's roll 1d20 plus 9.
I think that will hit.
Oh! So that would be 2d6 plus 4?
Mm-hmm.
So roll 2d6 plus 4. Not bad. 11.
Okay.
And cool. Then go to this one that was attacking me, attacking him. That's gonna hit.
That's gonna hit.
Mm-hmm. Plus 45, but helps if I put that space. Ah, only 5. So you gotta. Then we're gonna fly up in the air. Yeah, so we get some attack of opportunities.
Attacks. 23. Yeah. So 3 damage on that. And for the other one that's next to him.
Miss.
12.
So we're down to 44. And then he's gonna look down and he's gonna move himself and angle himself in a way that he'll be able to just get the 3 statues and a 30-foot cone. I'm assuming with 60 feet of flying that there's some way, shape, or form to get these 3 into a cone.
If you're aiming down, forward probably goes, I'm going to say, about half, so probably can only get those 3.
Yeah, it's just those 3 that I'm trying to get. I'm not trying to get, like, if others got hit, that's very on top, but these 3 are the main targets. So I need another dex saving throw. DC 17. Makes it.
Doesn't
fails.
Now it's going left to right.
So then it's going to be 6. So for the one that failed, it'll take 9 fire. The other 2 will take half. So 4.
Hey, every little bit counts.
Yep.
Alright. He's just going to float up there. The ceiling's not very high, so he can't get up too high. So, but
I'm guessing he could. Well, also, like, yeah, full portal. Okay, yeah, that's everything for me.
All right, time to engage. Nobody? Joke?
Engage? Alright, I was reading, sorry, what?
I said it's time to engage.
I don't get it.
His name is Gage.
His name is Gage.
I didn't realize it was his turn.
He's gauging your response.
Oh!
Gage rushes up to the, that was attacking the Ephemertrod, and a duplicate or a echo appears next to the one in front of Eldith, and he's gonna actually attack the one from Eldith. He misses with his first attack, and really he's making 2 attacks simultaneously, one from his echo, one from himself. So he's gonna make an echo back on the front of him. He hits. And... damage. This one is down. And he's going to unleash Formation. Make another attack from his Echo. The same one. And he whiffs.
No, but you don't you have advantage because you're...
Oh, I suppose he is. He would also have it with his first attack, so...
Yep.
We'll say the first... That was his advantage roll on that second one, so he still misses on the first one, but... Banner roll to see if there's a crit on this next one. Nope, 28. It does hit. Green 10 points. Killing this one. And he didn't move much, but I'll have his Echo move over here. Actually, he's going to move his Echo here. And he just moved. He's here.
Echo, Echo.
Here. And move here. Oh. He can technically have his Echo here and here. So he's basically giving Eldith and Jim Jar advantage on him. Syra.
Seeing Karad decimate them with fireballs, and the ones nearest by are being taken care of, he will run forward a little bit. 1, 2, 3, 4. And as she's passing by Holly, she'll just give a little quick grin. Disappear, and begin her flourish. So, on the first one, down there. Yeah. Oops, I have to roll an attack first.
Yeah.
Let's see. Why so difficult? Let's do this. 20.
That'll hit.
42. Next one.
Splitting this one. Gonna start in your row.
Damn. 17.
That misses.
Really? Right again. Super miss. Ooh, doesn't something happen when they miss?
Ooh, natural one.
Don't I get polymorphed?
Quite possibly.
Let's take a look on D&D Beyond. Whoa, Waggy. Yada yada yada, blah blah blah. Whenever you attack a creature with this weapon and roll a 1, you suffer the effect of polymorph for 1 hour.
Nope.
Yep.
Roll me a d20.
Here we go.
You're 12. Not a horse.
What? What?
I have anything for a horse? We need to get a horse. Hold on.
Need to see a man about a horse.
Horse? They're just a horse? Hmm. There's no gift horse.
A draft horse or a riding horse?
Ooh, definitely not a war horse. Let's see.
At least make me a riding horse. See, that's what I get for trying to show off. I made an ass of myself.
Wow, riding horses are big.
Ollie seeing this happen just laughs.
Yeah, they're a large beast. So that was on your... So which attack was that? Their third one?
Yeah, but that was a spell. So the spell's over now.
So, yeah, but I need to figure out where you're positioned.
I was on attacking this one.
So you started here, right? Then you attacked this one
basically,
and you flew to the next one, or are you allowed to stay at the
moment? I was still on that one.
Okay, we'll say you're right here.
Okay.
You're actually a horse. Right there. Hold on. You'll find in your journal a riding horse. Right.
Oh.
And the spell ends.
I have a zoo by time. This is all done. Alrighty.
I almost think that Holly will lose her rage by starting to laugh after seeing that. We'll see. Holly, what does Holly do?
I actually think that would, like... How would that
I'm not dictating. I'm making suggestions and thinking what they might do.
Yeah. Which would really suck. Yeah, I think she would drop out of rage just because of sheer hilariousness that Syra tried to show off and get turned into a horse for it.
I deserve it.
This is fair.
And Josh laughed too. Yeah, she drops out of rage and sadly she has no more rages to use. So... But that gives her a reason to be able to do this. We're just gonna stick with the tried and true Wamble Bamble combo of Reckless and Great Weapon Master. Hits this bitch. Fourteen's not gonna hit. She's still laughing too much.
Like.
And she gonna try again.
Huh? Yeah.
But a
20 hits.
20 will hit.
Yeah, it's dead. And two hit points.
It's definitely blown to smithereens. We'll just go right up to like here. That's it.
All right, Ron. Seeing that it's taken care of. Let me hold on. Oh, hey. Comes down to this one. Still in a rage. Reckless against this statue. Dunk. Apparently, it's just like there's a little nick in there. No damage. Lassiter, your boyfriend's obviously frustrated. His last couple of hits he hit, but his axe didn't really do anything.
Get over there and give him a pep
it
talk.
It happens. Just having performance issues.
Wow, you put your own boyfriend on blast like that? Damn.
It's a mental thought. Could I get a Eldritch Blast on this guy?
What's range?
Oh.
You have 120 feet, don't you?
Oh, yeah, 120 feet.
Then yes.
I believe that's the radius or the range.
I think I missed.
Yeah, a little far, you know, and one to Ront. But that's only one.
It's okay, big guy. I miss sometimes too. Is Ront still hurt? Any?
Let's see. No. He is hurt. Not to the point of being bloodied, but he is still hurt. He's less than his max hit points.
I will.
If you're going from like 1 to 45, it's like a 27.
I will get right here and use a healing word on Ront. Uh-oh, I did not mark down my last healing word. I shall do that now. Now healing word, Ront. Rolling. Wow, another 9. There you go. You're welcome.
For him... Oh, man. That one hit. For him, that was like a fifth of his health. So...
You're welcome.
Compared to other people... That was pretty good. Now it's the statue's turn. Alright.
What is the horse doing?
You just saw Syrah jab with her sword, whiff, and then all of a sudden, horse, she's probably a little dizzy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, nice. Boop. 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 Not raising anymore. Alright, we'll just start off with this one, which is still going after Jim Jar. Two slam attacks. Miss and a miss. Not to say they're good at their attack. Okay. The one next to Ront turns and looks at Ront, who just nicked his shoulder, and attempts to slam Ront. He did not go reckless last round, so a miss and a miss. We got one hitting the horse, completely whiffs. Doesn't have an ally nearby. So. They misses. Another one against the horse. Does the 19 hit a horse?
It certainly does.
Alright. The horse takes 4 damage.
Okay. I'm still up.
This one comes over and attempts to hit the horse. 15 hit. Question mark.
Yes.
All right. Take 7 points of damage.
Still up.
I'm assuming a 6 does not hit.
That misses. Okay.
Next one comes up and also attacks the horse. Assuming 20 hits for 8 damage.
And I poof back into Syra.
Poof. You are surrounded, but you are no longer a horse, but still surrounded by drow statues. As it, one final attack comes at you. For 20.
Would Blade Song have been deactivated
since I would became a horse? I would have to say it would have, yeah.
Then, yes, it hits.
Okay. Take 8 points of damage.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay.
These guys are not necessarily bright about tactics, by the way. Haven't quite noticed. This one's coming over and attacking around. For a... it's wrong, but he's raging. So he takes 2 points of damage. And another one misses Runt. I think I got all the drow statues. Aldis can attack the statue next to her. King sword. Got a shield, so it does 8 points of damage. Jimjar will try the same thing he was doing before. Oh, they have advantage. Let's start off with the short sword. This is... Jim Jar's not rolling well. Oh, there. There's one that hits. He does 12 points of damage. And it's still up. Crad!
All right. Gonna just move over here just so you could view of things. Where do we got him? So we're gonna do another glorious fireball from here.
One of them makes it. The rest failed.
So gonna be not sure why I didn't do it that time. But 33. Yes.
That's
because of plus 5. Mental stuff. Okay. Yeah. Not sure why I didn't do it this time, but. That's all I got for him.
Well, cleared out most of the battlefield.
We're gonna fly over here. Stay in the air so a breath weapon will just get the 2 statues.
Another deck.
8 damage. And then
the angles appropriately are so 8 damage.
What? So you do first rend on this one.
Misses. And that misses. Not doing well on those runs. Anything else? No, they both missed. What was the D6 plus 4?
That'd be all.
Okay, what was the D6 plus 4?
Does the 17 hit?
No.
Oh, sorry, I thought it hit.
Okay. Just checking.
Yeah.
Alright.
Sorry, my headset, my cord went out a little bit, so I didn't realize that until I was like, I saw your mouth moving, I'm like, oh.
Oh. Alright, Gage is gonna engage. I gotta stop doing it.
What are you, though?
Gonna send his Echo down here while he attacks this one. Advantage. That'll hit. Kills it. And all of a sudden, the shadow which he sent down here suddenly transforms into his regular gauge, and this one turns to shadow. One now gauge. Echo. As he swaps places and attacks. Not with advantage. And he misses. That's his turn.
Sarah is completely embarrassed of everything that's transpired, but trying to maintain some coolness, she's going to try and acrobatically leap over this one here to get over here.
Roll me an acrobatic check.
She has to be stylish. No. Face plant, go!
Fail!
You attempt to leap, attempt to do a very eloquent leap, a flip leap over the statue, and you fall flat in your face. And you don't make it to the other side of the statue. Like, actually, you don't fall flat in your face. You just go, all right.
And you just go,
and you fall back right back where you were.
And Holly's just like, it's just not your day today.
Leave me alone.
No.
So I am attacking the one in front of me.
Okay, 25 does hit.
Shoot some leftover fire to the one next to it. Okay, we're at 10.
14 damage total for the first one, and then 10 for the other one. Oh, the other one's dead.
And then one final thrust with her rapier. Six for 10. And she has the brightest red on her face.
So,
complete disappointment in herself.
Stab right into the statue, and it crumbles to dust that doesn't fall to the ground. It just kind of floats there. It's dust. It's like as if you had exploded the stone. But instead of actually exploding outward and just a bunch of pebbles and rocks. It just kind of turns into this misty, but very dry dust that starts filling the room.
Yeah,
get this chill of some sort of malevolence. I can pronounce.
Words are hard.
Backing away.
We are no longer.
4, 5, 6.
The dust cloud starts going over Gage and Holly, Ront, Jimjar, Eldith, and it reaches out, Thyra, Karad.
Before
Lassiter can exit the room, it engulfs him. You don't feel pain or anything. Just something is very upset. You can feel it in your bones.
Do we hear anything? Like what?
No. It's just like suddenly the room is just filled with this cloud of dust. Very dry.
And no matter
what, it hates you. But it is, you're not sure, but it feels like it's very angry.
Can I hold my breath?
Sure, if you want to. What's your constitution modifier?
Oh, no.
What's your con mod?
My bad. +2.
+2. Okay, so you can hold your breath for 2 minutes.
Okay.
Actually, I think it's like 1. I don't remember up in my head at the moment. But you can breathe and everything. It's just kind of dusty. Maybe it's a little coughing.
Arcana check or something that could
help
me understand.
Roll me an Arcana.
It's a +9 to that. Jesus. Alright, it's not my night for roll 20.
Not sure.
Is it allowing us to leave? Like, if we make our way towards the door, is it blocking our escape?
It looks like the door, the way is open.
We see.
Jimjar starts coughing and being like, "Oh my god, is it? We got to leave. Anybody got like some way to banish this thing? It's an exoplanar bane or something like that. I think it's Ogrémoch's bane.
I have to figure out
a way to get rid of it.
Can it be dispelled?
I'm actually about to do dispel magic."
Cast dispel magic and nothing seems to happen.
Well then, we need to leave. And right now.
Yeah, like, what?
And I shall.
I don't have banish anything, so.
In the way that I know where the exit was, I'm just going to try to see if a Thimbachar's Blaze, focused this way, will do anything to help disperse this stuff. Like a column of fire, just.
Niggins are not to avoid anybody. He breathes, and the room gets very warm. Cloud's still there?
Did me leaving help that feeling in any way?
You do, as you step out of the radius of the cloud of dust, you don't feel the malevolence anymore. Felt like you were inside Cyril, something.
And Cyril's going to call out, "Everyone, get out of there right now. Follow my voice."
Being in the cloud, can we tell where it's coming from?
Just around you. It's like you're inside this malevolent thing.
We'll take care of this later. Get out.
Yeah, like I'll prestidigitate like sparks out of my fingers to like give it a little flare. Like, over here.
Yeah, it probably does obscure your vision. It's not that much, so it's not like a full, like, obscure cloud. It's just a lot of dust in the air, so you can easily find your way out.
Jim Jar, what did you say that was?
Ogrémoch's Bane. It's a creature that has been taking control of some of our earth elementals. I think it's from some other plane of existence. I haven't been able to get rid of it. Sometimes we can't even find it.
Well, we found it. How do we get rid of it?
I don't know. What do you think I am? Some sort of magic user? I mean, you saw that, the big cloud of fire and everything. Didn't it look like it even do anything to the thing?
And I did try to get rid of it magically. The crowd will speak up, and nothing happened.
Oh, there you are, correct.
You did notice the whole damn time.
You did notice that the fire, kind of like the movement of the fire, did like move part of the cloud, but it didn't really do anything.
All right. So, we'll just put this on the list of things that we need to take care of, and let's take this head to the guy, or girl, I can't remember which one it was.
Follow the quest marker with the exclamation point over his head.
We gotta tell somebody, we gotta do something.
I agree, but we don't really know what to do, so let's do what we can right now and take care of this when we can.
I mean, you guys don't know, like, some sort of banishment smell or something like that? Maybe we can find something. I'm not sure what we have available. This is stock. Ginger looks terrified.
Correct. Maybe there's something in the bag of holding.
Or what? Get rid of the smoke?
I have no idea.
That's not smoke.
That's
a thing. That's a creature of some sort.
Brad said the right thing, Dustin didn't. Okay.
So here's the description of what happened according to. At the last statue crumbles, cloud of dust erupts from the shattered remains and expands to fill the cave. That's very anticlimactic.
Yeah. Being hell. Oh, wait. It's freedom of movement.
Well, then we could at least bring us to the attention of the keepers here. I mean, if this is something that's been known, that'd be going around.
Maybe it was contained in that statue. Maybe if we find another way to contain it. happening.
So now that we left, like, that whole presence that we felt is not around us anymore, correct?
But you're being out of the cloud, it seems that sense of malevolence has just... You do see some of the dust seems filling out.
Does anyone have a way to at least clog up that entryway?
He had a bunch of shrugs from the NPCs.
How big is the entryway?
I would say it's like a 20 foot high and wide entrance. Maybe 10 feet. 10 feet. 10 feet wide, 20 feet high.
That's perfect. All right. So, Holly, like, kind of will turn to Holly and just, like, find a medium sized bolt or rock and place it in front of the. Door.
Alright. How about you, as one of the strongest people in this group, go find a large rock?
What do you think I asked Holly to do?
Red's asking Holly to do it. Not Holly saying to do it. Have Holly roll a let's just do a perception check. I'm not going to send her too much.
It gets confusing sometimes.
You didn't see any boulders.
Big rocks, big rock. I'll look around and see if I can find one.
Maybe she's just being too pussy. It's like, I don't see any.
Actually, I should not help out.
Wow. Hey, why not? I'll try to.
There we go.
I see all the rocks. I am the rock.
Syra just as everybody's like looking around for a walk, just sighs and walks up to a boulder that's like directly in front of everybody, just like to the side, like here or something. That's just the side that's perfect for what Grad's looking for. Holly glares at Syra, goes over, just lifts the boulder, moves it over, and puts it in front of the doorway. You have your boulder, correct?
You look at the back. All right, so it's like in the doorway. Mm-hmm. Krat's gonna go up to it, cast enlarge on it.
Fills in the doorway, kind of. You had it like inside the door, right?
Yeah.
You wanted.
It's
up
gonna
the doorway,
like,
it goes.
Yeah.
Fills it up and it fills it up, kind of cracks the frames and everything, just from its, you know, it's half as wide as it was tall. But you know, kind of jams in there, pretty good. You see some. Kind of flipping through some cracks.
But it's not going to come in as fast. So. Yeah, good stop, yeah.
You could definitely say you slowed it down.
Yeah. Okay. This should hold.
How long does it last?
Probably a minute.
And I can't extend it.
It lasts for 1 minute.
Yeah, sadly I can't extend it. But I have a feeling like once it like shrinks, because it went from medium to large, it shrank and collapsed the door.
You can, are you going to stick around to nope. find out?
Nope. Right, we ain't.
What are you guys
doing? At least Brad isn't.
We got to tell the gods. Got to tell the gods. This way.
Technically, I'm a doctor. I can prescribe pills.
Sarah agrees with Jim Jar. He's going to follow after him.
That's Jim Jar runs down some steps back into a room you're very familiar with. Or you've been familiar with. Around the pools. You hear some fighting, sounds of fighting in the distance. He starts banging the door. Let us out! Let us out! Let us out! Oh, it's Ogrémoch's Bane! The doors are cranked open because they're awfully heavy. He comes through and says, "We got the Medusa. Who has the head?"
We put it in the bag of holding.
Okay.
So Brad will.
We have Medusa. There's
a weird cloud attacking.
Ogrémoch's Bane.
Trying to find it. Sark Axe Barrel was the guy who said he would offer you something. Like, calm down, breathe. Wait a minute, did somebody say Ogrémoch's Bane?
Yeah, that guy.
Yeah, we tried to slow it down, but we killed some statues, and all of a sudden it started filling a room, and he's just
killed as a horse.
Sark is just trying to calm Jim Jar, who's obviously terrified. He says when the guards is
we have to tell who's in charge of this place immediately.
Person is, or the general idea, but I can't remember.
His name is General Idea.
That makes sense. McIntyre?
This might help. Oh, yep, here we go. Contact Gurnick, Catfinger. Let him know. You might also want to contact Nomi Path Shredder. They might have some ideas what to do about this. Oh, jeez. Calm down, man. Jim Jar starts breathing less heavily. Well, you guys did the Medusa thing. Jim Jar's just kind of like flopped down on the ground, just catching and calming down.
Let's take this one step at a time. Let's get this head to where it should go. And then we'll inform whom we have to.
Oh, I was going to ask for the Medusa's head. He says, "Oh, no, I got payment for you." He goes over to a bag, hands 50 gold to each member of the party.
Money, 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 money.
Still broke.
You said 50, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We still have a bag of holding full of shit to sell.
To each person. So. Party.
Still broke.
Not as broke as NPCs, I'm assuming.
True.
In addition...
But to be fair, I blew a bunch of money on spells, so I can't complain.
You just did, so yes, you can.
I can, but it doesn't mean much.
For the proof that the Medusa is dead, I present you with this, and he holds up a beautiful, pristine diamond. I'd say this fetch you a 1,000 gold pieces. Seeing Grad with the bag of holding, he tosses it over to Grad.
Or can bring somebody back to life. If Lassiter ever gains that level to get that spell.
If he ever keeps going cleric.
I think I have a revive.
You said it was 1,000?
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I have it.
Revivify only requires 300 gold pieces of diamonds. So, using this diamond, you might want to break it down, and then you would have 3 revivifies. Otherwise, you're wasting about 700 gold pieces. Because it's one diamond.
So maybe not.
Even though his stat is 500, and I think Resurrection is.
I think Resurrection is very expensive. Resurrection is. Wait for it.
Not true Resurrection, but.
Resurrection is 1,000.
Oh, perfect for Resurrection.
True Resurrection is 25,000. But anyway. Well, thank you for this, but we really should get away from this area as quickly as possible. Do you think these doors will slow it down even more?
We'll definitely slow it down. We'll have to take care of it. We'll have to figure out how to take care of it. So, we'll keep a guard on it, keep watch until we get some guidance. Or some help from either the priest or the Earth Elemental Wrangler. Pass out your tap finger. Or both. They might consult with each other.
Well, can you?
Everybody in Blingdenstone has a Jersey accent.
Well, since you seem to know so much about this, why don't you lead us towards the priest first. Maybe they'll be able to tell us more about this and why it's occurring.
Yeah, sure. They'd be over in the speaking stones, I think.
Alright, well, let's go then.
Yeah, set out here, and Jim Jar leads the way over in here, where a circle of of stone menhirs predating Blingdon stone stand in the center of this small cavern. It looks kind of like a henge. Looks like just a circle.
Okay. And do we see anyone there?
Not at the moment.
If we wait a few minutes, do we see anything?
Well, rather than just waiting, the stones themselves, do they have any markings on them, or?
No, they just pretty much look like big old boulders. You hear a voice behind you say, we think those are some ancient Galabdors.
She'll turn to see who's speaking.
And you see,
I really don't like people behind me.
You see a deep gnome in what looks to be like some sort of priestly robes. And says, "Hello, my name is Gurnik Taptinger. Do you have some interest in the speaking stones? How can I?"
Well, fascinating that they could be Galabdur, but we came here for another reason. We believe the tunnels are filling with Ogrémoch's Bane. Are you aware of this? Or do you know what this is?
I am aware of it. One second. He reaches into a pouch and he pulls out a ruby. Says, "I'm not much of a fighter, but there is a way to consecrate the grounds inside of what we're currently calling Rockblight. I'm assuming was where you found this."
It was released from a grouping of drow statues that came to life and fought us.
Drow? It must have been from the initial invasion and must have been petrified by the Medusa. That would be another creature that you would need to take care of.
Oh, that has already been done, but we were caught up in the cloud of this bane. It just filled us with this malicious feeling, this hate.
Well, sounds like time is of the essence. I ask that you go back there. There is a temple of the gods that has been desecrated. If you place this on Place this gem in the steadfast stonesman here, it should essentially cast the hallow spell. Just beware that Ogrémoch's Bane servants may attempt to stop you. But if you succeed, I may be able to assist you without any additional need. Also, it will consecrate the grounds and hopefully drive off Ogrémoch.
What does it do to people exactly?
Well, it's some sort of creature. We assume that it's from a plane of Earth. It can take control of any creature that is native to the plane of Earth, such as our Earth elementals. Also, the Galabdurs and a creature known as the Zorns are several examples of creatures that would be affected by it. It is possible that When you place this on the steadfast stone, take a moment to activate. But I'm assuming some sort of servants, most likely earth elementals you saw I have control over, will attempt to attack you. Defend. Defend long enough for the spell to take effect. Then the temple will be cleansed.
Well, since none of us are earth elementals, we'll be relatively safe to pass through this bane as we take care of it, at least from its effects.
So you were surrounded by it. Is that correct?
Yes, we were all engulfed by it.
Have you felt any ill effects since you left it?
I don't believe so.
It is mainly because you are not a creature from the plane of Earth. You may provide malevolent emotions for it to feel what it is feeling. But without having the servants, which he can take control of, he cannot necessarily harm.
Okay. Well, since it's a holy object we'll be transporting, I assume our resident holy man will be carrying it for us.
Or
holy-ish man.
What does this thing look like?
Just a ruby.
Oh.
Syra, I think you would automatically be able to tell this is a ruby spell gems.
Since she's already carrying one with Bigby's hand in it.
Oh.
In this case, it would. He mentioned that it would. It's probably the hollow spell.
Right. Yep.
I'll just add it to. What color is it? Ruby? Oh, red. Okay.
Is there an incantation to speak to activate it, or just placing it should begin the spell?
Just placing it on the stone will be enough. And then defending the location for the spell to take effect.
Understood. And she'll politely bow to her and start to walk away. How's everyone feeling after all that excitement?
Can I do like my little checkup on everyone?
Gage is fine.
Health-wise, I am fine. Spell-wise, half-tapped.
Ront is a little injured. Elvis is injured. Jim Jar is fine.
Can I do some, like, little bandaging here and there to, like, maybe...
Without spells?
Yeah.
You could take a short rest.
Do you have a healer's kit?
I do. Wait, I thought I did. Yeah, I do.
Otherwise, you could take a short rest and seeing your current wounded state, I would say that the priest Gurnick would say, feel free to take a rest. I believe after the fight you had it. I believe that based off of what you've told me about the situation, that we should be able to enter that we are currently safe. from any incursions that may happen. I believe you definitely have slowed him down. He can't, as far as I can tell, he can't really move that fast.
So short rest.
Or a long rest. He's basically giving you permission to take a long rest.
Saying, hey, you're good for now, for the night.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
I will assure that wards are placed on the gates.
Thank you for your hospitality and,
anything understanding that would be affected, because it will are moved away from the location.
Yeah, I have something to drink around here.
Maybe you mean like at the inn where we're staying?
Yeah, like that.
At the floating mug. Or the foaming mug.
Oh, are we staying there for the night?
Yeah, that's where our rooms are.
Okay, cool. And I will drink up.
And there's four drinks when he had like a short and long rest button.
Come on.
I know I can do it on D&D Beyond, but just...
Hope he paused the recording.
Well, you can consider that a moment of break. Strangely, it was somebody.
Take a break.
It was somebody from work, but they hung up before I actually or missed it by the time. But I'm not working right now. Don't call me. He didn't even text me.
My mind always assumes the worst. Oh, don't worry.
And if he wonders, well, why don't you answer? I'll be like, oh, I had my phone on mute. And I did. It was my computer that was ringing. Anyways, moving on. So everybody's returning to the foamy mug.
Yep.
Have some drinks.
Some food.
I didn't get
a long rest.
However, I feel like I deserve it.
You know? It's like you lost something at that time.
Lassiter makes his nightly con save.
I don't know, did you still have your...
No, I'm gonna take it off for the night.
Yeah. You can make me a constitution save before.
If I remember how to constitution saving throw.
Okay, find saving throws and click on the number.
I have indeed in a few. Sorry. 15.
Okay. You easily, when you have beverages, you get a little bit fun. Yeah, you get to the point where you've got that like nice buzz. Depends on how well you control yourself.
Lassiter control himself? What?
As I said, depends on how well he controls himself.
I mean, am I still coherent? Can I?
I mean, you just proved it. You're not so coherent. Coherent.
And I guess I'll chill for the night.
Oh, being reasonable.
I think I'm going to change some spells around.
Unless there's unless someone else wants to do something.
Before you get the time in the kitchen.
So, we're going to do something. because I read some place test material. Lasser and Karad, and go to sleep. Feel something that makes you feel a little different. And Lasser, you know, consult. You know, kind of do a little communion in the morning. You can take care of your cleric spells, but the warlock spells are always the same. You're just kind of stuck that way. But something feels, you feel the draconic presence of your patron, and he says, "Ah, laddie, you can change him out. That's fine. If you need something else, let's just let you know." Karad, you feel the power of the dragon. You actually feel a little bit warmer inside you. And you feel meditate on it can change out your spells. I am giving you the option to prepare your spells for any spell casting class.
Ooh.
Which is one of the playtest things for 1D&D. And I'm like, that makes so much more sense.
So pretty much what's happening is we can change our warlock spells.
Yep. Sorcerer for Karad and warlock for you.
Oh,
I mean, you can do that before with your cleric spells, but
yeah,
with your warlock spells.
I had asked a question on what's it called, Discord, but we're not doing anything now. So could I use a spell that it's homebrew? It's pretty much the spirit guardian spell, but instead of casting on myself, I can cast it on a teammate, and it would follow them instead.
I would say no. But if you ever got sorcery points, I would allow that for metamagics.
Okay.
Not necessarily having to take a metamagic thing, but like one spell or one sorcery point per level of the spell, that sort of thing.
Okay.
Something that's normally self you allow to cast on someone else, but you would have to have 3 points. I mean, there's feats to give you sorcery points. That would work one way, but you would have to get to a level with that and get yourself that feat.
Okay. Cool beans. Just was wondering.
There has to be more of a cost than just a spell slot.
And that sounds very sorcery, honestly.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, I was going to change my spells, but...
Well, as a wizard, you can. As long as it's in your spellbook.
Yeah. Just what I have in my spellbook is...
Like, there's not a lot of spellcasters where you can get spellbooks from down here.
Yeah, true. Although, since we were hinted at what we're fighting, this, well, I say that, but then it might not hold. But it would waste a turn for them, so that might be beneficial too. Sure. I'm not using that, so I'll add.
Unfortunately, only the actual PCs are the only ones that cast spells.
Well, that could be another point to bring up. Do we actually want to bring the NPCs with us?
To Earth?
Hmm?
to the battle with us, or?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I'm gonna say they, but the NPCs, not Gage or Holly, but the rest of them are gonna gain a level. After those fights, it's gonna.
I believe I'm ready.
Yeah, same. You would
say that, and I'm like, really? Am I that? Yeah, I'm done.
Making sure that everybody's taking a long rest. Level 5.
Do 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 do.
I've got fast movement. He can now move 40 feet.
If he's a level 5 barbarian, he should also double attack now, too.
He get extra.
He should.
Yeah, he got extra attack, and so did Eldis. What Eldis? Oh, this.
Yeah.
Here it is.
Eldis is a fighter, isn't she? Or a barbarian?
A fighter. Wants the barb. Jinjar's the rogue. So he's got a bad luck on the. He did get uncanny dodge, though. Right. Up to you whether you actually want the NPCs to come or not. Or just stick with your party of five.
I vote just the 5 of us.
All right.
Do you all wake up from a good rest? Maybe have some breakfast?
I make my special mushrooms for sure, Syra, Holly. You gain temporary hit points, 4 temporary hit points.
Here.
Gage as well. And I'll just hold on to one right now to see if we might need it. So I can make 4. Bless you.
You did, so I wouldn't be sneezing into you.
With my necklace on, I would like to ask, let's call her Susie, for 5 cups of 5 things of ale.
She says 5 gold.
5 gold it is.
And within seconds.
Within seconds, you have 5 mugs there.
Is this real ale? Or does it look watery?
It looks like the ale that you drank last night.
Okay.
Another ale.
Just making sure.
Tastes like it. Smells like it.
Yep. And I'll just start chugging those things.
Actually, it tastes like water.
Yeah.
Right. You're wearing that thing.
Like, and I guess I'll have a potato with it or whatever. I don't know.
I'm sorry. It's mashed brown.
Carby breakfast.
A softened potato. Not just a potato. A potato that's been boiled or whatever.
You want like hash browns?
No, I just want a potato. A softened potato. I want to eat the potato.
You know, oil them, mash them, stick them in the stew.
I'm just like, what's breakfasty? Hash browns, you know? It's potato. It's cooked a certain way.
I realize that, but I am asking for a whole potato, but softened.
It brings you out a plate of mashed potatoes.
Thank you. Not what I asked for, but
you said you wanted a softened lighting, and this is the softest I can get you. Takes a while. But it brings you out of I don't know.
I'll drink my drinks and I'll eat my potato. Wait for the others.
Yep. Sarah's just double checking her spell book and flipping through and studying her spells, and she closes the book, places it on her hip, and she's ready to go.
Ooh, at some point I was saying, Susie, what do you do when you're not working here?
Okay, so she's not dwarf, she's a rock gnome, so I need to do it with the Jersey accent. She's like, look, I'm not Susie, my name is Tappy. I've told you this over and over again.
Okay, let's be honest, I'm not going to remember your name, so...
Well, I'm not going to answer to anything but my name, and if you don't say my name, I'm not answering.
That's fair. I accept that. But for now, what do you do when you're not working? Tabby.
Tabby looks at you and just goes, none of your business.
Is Karad nearby yet?
Yeah.
Oh.
Probably in the kitchen.
Okay. Well, my friend over there, he kind of was asking about you the other day, and I told him that I'd get your info for him.
Karad, hearing this, will message him saying, lying son of a bitch.
You'll love me. Don't worry.
No, I don't.
Roll me a deception check.
Me?
No, Lasser.
16?
No pip.
Yeah. He's a good looking guy.
Yeah, I think so. Alright.
Meets it, beats it.
She looks at you and is like,
I'm sorry, what was that?
She just says, "Rye." Like, she's being condescending.
Wow. Well, your loss. I'll just eat my potato.
Eat your mashed potatoes?
Yep.
I mean, it really is mashed potato. She only did one. So it's like this big. It's barely much of potatoes.
Sorry, Karat. I tried.
I literally call out, "I hate you."
She just rolls her eyes and walks back into the kitchen. She just pats Karat's shoulder. Says, "Don't worry about it. I know he's lying to his teeth."
I will literally light your pants on fire next time I am within vicinity of you.
Can I watch that?
Yes.
See, y'all making up already.
I have this vision of, after Lassiter says that, that both Karat and Tappy just kind of like look back like, what?
And at that point when I look back, I will create bonfire on his pants.
Is there a save throw?
Yeah, there's a dex save to that.
Alright, roll me a dexterity saving throw, Lassiter.
Ooh. 19.
I'm assuming there's half damage, right?
Is a cantrip, so no.
So you narrowly dodge as a blazing bonfire appears next to you.
Get up. Yell.
Not cool, man.
I told you I was gonna do it.
Oh, I'll take my plate of potato and just take it to another table. Eat alone where I'm wanted.
How far away are you?
Ron sits down next to you and says, "No, it's probably not a good idea to antagonize your party." Any of your party members, right?
I wasn't antagonizing, I was
especially the one that controls fire!
I was trying to make everyone
antagonize the tunneling all the time.
I want to get it out of here as much as you do, but probably one of the best ideas is, unless they ask you to try to help them, just leave it. Because he could have light your pants on fire, and don't get me wrong, I would find that hilarious myself, but I need that part of you to be safe.
Alright, fine.
Yeah, and Syrah, if I put as half as much energy into Holly as I do with Karat, probably more shit would happen, but I'm not doing that with Holly, because it's not my character.
It's all good.
It's like when you ask, like, what's this that Hollywood do, like, afterwards, all this? I'm like, I don't know. It's not my character.
You should one day just sit down with.
I literally asked. I messaged him and asked him those questions, so he told me. That's how I got the answers, finally.
He's remote controlling.
Pretty much. Yeah. Most of the time, he hears what I say, so.
So you have you all have a interesting breakfast, and you said that Gage, Holly, and Syrah got the temp HP.
Yeah, four.
I mean, let's be fair. I only antagonize Holly because she doesn't. She doesn't see my beauty anymore as everyone else does. She's competing against me.
No, I understand fully where you're coming from.
One day I was the beautiful queen of the kingdom, and then Snow White appeared. That 14-year-old hussy.
It's all in good fun for Lassiter, too.
And lighting your pants on fire is all good and fun for Crad.
Understandable. I'll accept that.
Alright. So what are you guys doing?
We have a cloud to take care of, I think.
Air flip. Sorry, I'm dilly wibble with his foot and chat. No one's talking, we're just watching the chat go away.
I was just doing that because other people were talking. So.
Before we go back to the gate to go through, does anyone want to do any shopping or selling of all that stuff? That'd be a good idea. Since we have that store with our, I believe, 25% discount?
Sure.
Did you write it down? We do have a bunch of stuff to sell. And I mean bunch. Like,
maybe they have magic items.
Give me, like, let's take a short, like, a break so I can literally count, like, to the math and how much we actually have. A lot of this stuff has been since, like, the beginning.
Well, you haven't really found a good market.
No, I fully understand, but it's just like we've been hoarding shit.
Well, yeah, if you want to buy a hovel here in Lindenstone to live out your you're gonna be kind of you said you were gonna become an agent at the thing.
Yeah,
you're gonna basically be Tappy's sous chef or chef. He's the owner of the chef.
Hey, when are we ignoring the attunement thing for the spell gems? Or do I have to attune to them to use them?
Well, you've had it since night, so...
Okay, so... It requires attunement by a caster if seeking to imbue the gem.
Ah.
So you don't have to attune to it unless you're going to be putting a spell into the gem.
Cool.
If you're just using the spell that's already in the gem, you don't have to be attuned. So you could unattune something, spend an hour to attune to it, put the spell in, and then once you're done with that, unattune.
I wish we could upgrade magic items somehow.
All right. I would need to get prices on some of these stuff. Right. Do we want to hold on? I'm guessing we want to hold on to the spell scroll of freedom of movement.
Yes, sir.
Would anyone have any reason to think of for a thing of oil of slipperiness?
It might come in handy.
Isn't oil inherently slippery?
This is extra slippery.
Magic is slippery.
Makes sense.
It grants the creature the effects of... Yeah, okay, yeah, because it grants the creature that gains the effect of freedom of movement for 8 hours. So the only thing I guess for sure would be the Quell's Feather token. Tree.
What does that do?
It makes a tree. You must be outside to use this token. You can use an action to touch it to an unoccupied space on the ground. The token disappears, and in its place, a non-magical oak tree springs into existence. The tree is 60 feet tall and has a 5-foot diameter trunk, and its branches has a top spread at the top spread out in a 20-foot radius.
Well, see, as we've been underground for
down here.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've been underground for months on that, so probably not.
So that I would need to get a price on, for it is a rare item, magical item.
It is a rare magical item.
Because I'm holding on to any potions we have.
I'm looking at Xanathar's here. But we have a problem with this item. The item will not work in the Underdark.
No, but the people at Blindenstone do do stuff with people on the surface. So,
yeah.
There is a market.
I will say, I'm going to have you do your negotiation roll.
Okay.
But I'm modifying where the adjustments will be.
Okay. So persuasion?
So roll me a persuasion check.
It's wall all over again.
It's like, very interesting. Not very useful down here. Getting into the markets to sell to the surface is going to be a little bit difficult. It is a very rare item. Give you 4,000 gold for it.
Sold. And then everything else, total, like 100% total, is 4,116. But actually, I'm going to take 1,000 off of that, because I'm guessing we're going to hold on to the diamond.
I want to hold on to the diamond, yes.
So 3,116.
You know what? I apologize, because that's a one-time use thing, right?
Yes.
Okay. I apologize if we'd be 2,000.
Still, that's 2,000 more than what we got for. We got it for free, so that's a gain of 2,000.
So, just to kind of pull back the curtain, I'm using Xanathar's for figuring out the base price for a rare item is 4,000, but half for a consumable, right?
Yeah.
Based off of your persuasion roll, normally 1 to 10 is 50% of the base price. 11 to 20 is 100% of the base price, and 21 plus is 150. Due to the current nature and situation, because we still have to go through all the work of trying to get it to somebody on the surface who could use it, I bumped that up by like 5. So, you were just under getting more money.
Yeah. Which is fine. Like you said, we got this, like, what? In a dungeon or something. So, we didn't pay for this. So, get of the 3,116, we need to get half of that. If I'm not mistaken. Because, like, daggers and crossbows and crossbow bolts. Some.
Yeah, miscellaneous things that no one's using.
Gems.
Yeah, that's all basically half their regular price.
Okay. Alright. So we got 2,000 for the token, right? That's 3,000. So, total 3,558. Alright. And now I can go through. So, yeah, we got a good amount of money if people want to shop. Probably be good to get some more health potions.
Any armor for sale?
Sadly, in this market, there is no armor.
Okay.
Is there like a jeweler around? Someone that can break up the diamond into, say, like $100 increment, 100 gold increments?
And do you do kind of like 100 gold diamonds?
Yeah, that way, like, we can just use like 3 for revivify and stuff and being able to.
Yes. Give me another persuasion check to find out how much it would cost for the service.
Tearing out my bag of gold.
Right. Oh, well, Kazook actually, who sells spell gems, looks at it. Ooh, this is a very nice diamond. You just want this broken down to be about hundreds?
Yeah, just nice group of, like, 100 gold increments.
Might take me some time.
We have time.
I would say probably take me a couple of days to properly break this down and still have the exact amounts. It's very difficult. We'll say 10% of the value, so 100 gold pieces.
Fine. Easily done.
So, Zook will estimate that it will take 2 days to break it down.
Which we can't even use the spell yet. So, right, Lassiter, you don't have Revivify yet? You're not third level or something?
I do have Revivify.
You do?
Yes.
Okay. Do you have some diamonds for sale? Like, in the meantime, can we buy 300 golds worth of diamonds?
Let's see here. I guess I do. So, an additional 300 gold for that. So, total of 400 if you want to break your big one down to 10 diamonds. And if you wish, I can just take this out of the diamond itself.
What do you guys think? Like, we have a ton of gold. That's insane for the group. We have over 4,000.
Spend the gold, keep the diamonds, and get 300 more gold more worth of diamonds? Or...
I think we're okay for right now.
So just spend the gold.
This probably isn't required or anything, but can I incite this guy?
Sure. Okay. So what are you really trying to insight in regards to this?
I honestly don't know. I feel like he's scamming us in some way.
Okay. So you kind of look at him with a little side eye, and then you do the math in your head and be like, okay, so they're saying 100 gold for the service to break down the diamond. And you're also going to be purchasing, in addition to the diamond, breaking down the diamond, an additional 300 gold pieces worth of diamonds. And But they're also giving you the option that
instead of getting gold worth of diamonds, we get 700 gold worth of diamonds in 48 hours and not have to spend gold now. Or just we can of the
You would get six.
I gave the 100 gold him 100 gold for the fee. So we would get
gold is spent. Okay, so yes. We're just talking about the 300
yes
gold pieces for the diamonds of your, that you're purchasing. So yes. Basically, when you come back to pick out get the broken down diamond, you would get instead of 1,000 gold pieces worth of smaller diamonds that you could easily divvy up into 100 gold pieces of diamonds, you would end up with 700 gold pieces of diamonds without paying the 300 for the diamonds that she gave you. You would, in the end, it would be a net 1,000. Yeah. You spent 100. You just wouldn't have spent 300 gold. You wouldn't have given them 300 gold pieces.
Pay now or pay later, pretty much.
Okay.
But my thought is, we are well off in money right now.
So you could have 1,300, or you could have 1,000. In the end.
1,300, that's four revivifies.
I'm fine with whatever y'all decide.
Okay, 400 gold pieces.
Sorry, what did you say, Syrah?
Let's just save our money and hope for a more stock. Yeah. I think we're pretty safe as far as
spend gold, have more reagents. Spend less gold, yeah. Have less reagents.
Okay, we'll just have them take it off at the end.
Okay. So, you give him the 1,000 gold piece diamond. He provides 300 gold pieces worth of diamonds. Which would basically be the equivalent of the materials needed for the revivify spell.
Which I'll hand to Placeter.
You also have given them 100 gold pieces to break it down. Mm-hmm. And then when you come back in two days, actually, probably, yeah, in 2 days, they will provide you with 700 gold pieces of diamonds.
Okay, what exactly am I being given?
300 GP worth of diamonds.
Okay.
Should be the cost of a revivify spell. And the thing is, it's 300 worth of diamonds. It doesn't have to be a single diamond when it comes to revivify, yeah. if I remember the wording correctly. Of course, a full for the resurrection spell, if you had anybody that was high enough level, of just one diamond, you would require a single diamond worth 1,000 gold pieces. So you are basically sacrificing that by breaking it down. But I think both Raise Dead and Revivify, I think, is diamonds, plural. You just need the total value, but if I remember correctly, it could be wrong.
I just added a diamond.
I know Revivify is diamonds.
I just added a diamond to my inventory and made it...
Raise Dead is a diamond.
Okay. Is there anything about that you need an actual just singular diamond that's worth that much?
Yes.
Okay. But no one can cast that spell, so kind of not needed.
Yeah, because that's fifth level.
Is there anywhere nearby that sells magic items?
Because it looks at you and goes like, what am I? Chop liver? What are you looking for?
Are you?
I mean, that's why I sell.
You sell chopped liver?
Spell. No, I sell magic items and spell gems.
Oh.
This is my market. This is what I'm here for. I mean, well, we only got so much here. You were here the other day!
You can't count on me to remember where I am. I'm a drunk.
But you're not.
I'm gonna do something about that. You don't look drunk right now. You look completely sober.
I've had practice.
Maybe you've been drunk and now it's got some brain damage? I don't know. I don't know you. Not that well, at least. I've met you before, so I kind of know you, but not to the point where I know you about your drinking habits, but still.
Anyways, can I have a view of your wares? Look around.
Let's see what she has. Hold on. Click a link. Okay. There's your shop there, right here. Yeah, we'll call this one. Well, let's see. We got the mace here, which has been enchanted. They got this little amulet here. It's very clockwork-like. I got some of this. She puts a bag and says, there's a bunch of dust in here. It causes people to start sneezing and choking. Let's see. I got this Eyes of Charming. I do have some potions of healing, if you need those. And I do have 3 scrolls.
Those potion of healing sound nice. What is that amulet?
This one.
Amulet.
Siren's listening to the powder and the potions. She's like, eh. And then she hears squirrels, and she's like, oh, excuse me.
I mean, the powder does sound interesting, but for personal use.
This amulet is a clockwork amulet.
Interesting. What does it do?
Yeah, well, you make it if you're trying to attack somebody, instead of like rolling a d20, you get rolling the d20 to get a 10. Rolling the d20, get a 10 on the die. You can basically take 10. You make an attack roll, but you can only like use it once a day.
How much are the?
I almost want to make it like twice a day, but you know, once a day.
Unless anyone has interest in an amulet, how much are the healing potions?
How many healing potions? Standard rate. They're just regular healing potions. They're like 50 gold each.
How many do you have?
Let's see here. I have 6 of them.
Karad, 6 healing potions, 50 gold each.
300 gold pieces.
Oh, 300?
Well, I mean, in total, it's 300 gold pieces.
Oh, shit, okay.
Do you think we get a
bit of an individual potion is 50 gold pieces. There are 6 of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, think since if we buy all 6, you think we get a little bit of a discount?
That sounds fair. Discount,
didn't you?
Yep, 25%.
Can I help out with that persuasion check if it's needed?
I don't want your help.
Oh.
Burn.
Sick.
He just tried to
hit. All right, I was hoping you would forget about that. It's 225 gold pieces then.
That's acceptable.
For the lot of them, you know.
Yes.
Well, it's 25% off. What do you expect?
Oh, yeah. We do have that 25% discount. What is a discount on top of that discount?
There is no discount on top of discounts. There is no way you could persuade me otherwise.
What if Holly shows you her boobs?
What was those scrolls you had?
Let's see here. They're nothing too bad. There's like comprehend languages. I think this one was prestidigitation or something like that. I know it's hard to pronounce sometimes, but this. I don't know why, but this one I haven't been able to open because every time I just get drowsy.
That one's probably sleep.
Oh.
You know what? That sleep could come in handy.
It is a slightly cursed magic scroll which makes you drowsy if you hold it in your hand. The difficulty, if you need to make a spell check on this, is a lot more difficult. Because you're like, blink, blink.
Actually, I think it... Didn't I? Yeah, no, never mind. I checked that spell.
It's a drowsy spell scroll of sleep.
Yeah,
drowsiness just by holding on to it.
And I took sleep, so we're good.
I think that's it, unless anyone else wants anything.
Nope, I'm good.
Is there anything that you are keeping from our sights? Maybe.
No, this is what I got right now.
Under the table type.
Ask me in a couple days. Might get some, acquire some new things, but.
Yeah.
As of right now, I got those. I got a few other spell gems, but. Yeah.
Thank you for your.
Most of them are currently empty, so. Yeah, you can buy a spell gem, like just a raw spell gem. You can.
Oh, we have two of those. We're fine.
All right. Like we're not a bustling city right now, so stock is limited.
Understandable. As I'm leaving, I'll say this place is a piece of shit.
Yeah.
Gear behind you. For now.
Meanwhile, this is
kind of agreeing with you. It's like, no, it is currently a piece of shit. But...
it's just Karad's future home that he's going to plan to live in. This place is a piece of shit.
He'll help bring the value up or something. I don't know.
I think you're going to find another bonfire under your pants pretty soon.
No, I don't mean to offend.
I don't mean to offend, but it's still a piece of shit.
It's just truth.
Yeah, you do.
Well, one of the guards passed by as you say, it's still a piece of shit. And I'm like, yeah, this place is still a piece of shit. Don't worry. It's going to get better. Don't worry about that. We just have to take care of it. Anyways,
I have faith.
You try to walk by.
Anyway.
The foaming mug is... definitely not a piece of shit. It's one of my favorite places.
I can see why.
Should we get to business?
Yes, please.
Wild killing?
To defeat The Huns.
Right. So we'll actually... We're using Jim Jar. Jim Jar is not with you. You go back. You meet with the priest is there, seeing to overseeing some wards. You see Sark there. Sark says, we kept like a watch after every couple of hours. We opened the gate to check to see if we see the cloud or anything like that. We didn't see anything. We haven't seen nothing. So we assume if it did move, it hasn't moved very far. So I'm assuming that where you're going might, because actually draw the path. I'm not sure if you can see it on the map. But if you just come out the door, you take a right, just go take a right and then take a left up the stairs. There will be a place where you can go up some more stairs and you'll see the stone where you need to place it. From my understanding, there's supposed to be some guards that are around it, like as you make sure that as you're defending, as the spell is starting, some guards may appear. They shouldn't attack you. But anything else that does attack you, please attack and take care of until the spell is over. And once it's done, you should be fine. Everything should be okay. If you see Ogrémoch's Bane, I think it will like cause it to withdraw, but it may not actually like leave. If you can do anything about Ogrémoch's Bane as well, then... Oh, I mean, godsend.
Do you have any ideas that of ways to deal with it?
From our understanding, it's a being from the elemental plane of Earth. But really, the only real way to really like get rid of it would be to like banish it or something like that. As well as dispel good and evil. I'm not sure if you've heard of that spell. Might do it. Anything like that. Anything that will send somebody else to a different plane. Then you're back to the plane of Earth will be just fine.
Knew that. I remember there was a reason I take that spell.
I didn't have something to go back to where they came from.
Good luck. And Sark and some of the guards salute you. And they open the gates. And if I go away from drawing, move over to you. For some reason, you have the strange feeling that there is a green string that is leading you directly to where you need to go.
Oh. Someone cast find the path.
I'm not sure if you can see the string.
I saw that it was like a tiny little thing, I'm like, oh, now I see.
I have clairvoyance.
All right, let's march along.
Remember the right. Stairs?
Mm-hmm.
You see before you, as you climb up the stairs, a cloud of dust filling the hallway. They seem to be creeping up some stairs across the way.
Like, we see, like, a bulk of it, or just, like, a little bit?
It's basically filling in this this entire area down here. So these stairs go up. These stairs go up.
The
perspective, whenever I look at this, is it goes down, but it's not going down, it's going up.
So, with my, like, our, the details we were given about Ogrémoch's Bane, is it like a single entity? Or is it like a cloud of entities?
The way they speak of it seems like a single entity.
Okay.
What I see here is a cloud of of what looks to be dust. If you would like more information, you're very welcome to roll me an Arcana check.
No, with what they told.
Do it?
Yeah, just give me one moment.
You're 26.
Yeah. Alright, so yeah, that's what we're gonna do. So, I'm going to... You just see kind of like Crad just try like stretching his fingers and doing everything, and just like this, his eyes flare green or red with fire. Some light starts building up in his hands, and he's going to heightened cast banishment on spending 3 sorcery points. He's going to heightened cast banishment on this. So I need a
heightened cast you.
I can spend 3 sorcery points to make them roll a disadvantage.
Who?
Whenever they have to or force a creature to make a saving throw. So, 4th level banishment, charisma check, charisma saving throw.
Mm-hmm.
And they get a 17. And they have it at disadvantage.
The dust seems to just suddenly drop to the ground.
Did we do it?
I just need a... Just give me a minute.
Minute passes. Nothing. There's no new cloud of dust or anything.
We are good.
What exactly did you do?
I sent it back to the Earth Elemental Plane.
Oh.
It is not of this world, so I did banishment. So it sends as long as I maintain concentration for a minute, it sends it back to the plane of where it's from, and it stays there.
So do we have any places where we...
So.
I like how the description is, the target is native to a different plane of existence than one you're on. The target is banished with a faint popping noise. The only thing is, I didn't hear a faint popping noise.
I have a feeling that, like, because of, like, the meta magic and, like, just the fact that it's sorcerers, it'd be a little bit different.
Maybe. And with that heightened cast, you killed it.
It was just like,
You can't.
That's why I love
it. It passed. But then it was at disadvantage.
Like, that's why I freaking love sorcerers. Metamagic is so fucking awesome.
Alright. You climb the stairs and you find a nice little steadfast stone. The floor of this cavern is worn smooth, but the walls are rough. Or the floors are worn smooth, but the walls are rough. Great menhir. Carved from a stalagmite, stands in the center of the chamber, pockmarked with dozens of empty sockets that might have once have held gems.
Well, let's complete our mission, everyone. Let's put these restless souls to rest. And wait for Lasser to place the gem.
Yeah. I'll go in the middle? Do I just have to cast a spell?
You were told all you need to do is place a gem.
Oh, okay. Well, cool. I'll just place the gem there.
Place the gem in the socket, and the ruby begins to glow against the menhir. After a minute, emerging from the ground, let's see if I get a hand out of this. Here's a creature that looks like this.
Hello, dear.
He's so adorable!
It's a cutie, isn't it?
Oh my!
And it's from the ground near the menhir, and it faces outward in a guardian pose.
They have the best names. Kalibdur.
Kalibdur. Dasha is just like, is that Stool's final form?
No.
No, it's a earth elemental. But it's so fucking adorable. Oh my god.
So one of those appears next to the menhir and just kind of gets into a guardian position facing outwards from the menhir.
Brad would, like, being a dwarf from the Underdark and all that, Brad would gush over how adorable that thing is.
Yeah. It doesn't seem to move or anything. It just kind of, like,
yeah,
appears there in the guardian pose. About another minute passes. Another one of them comes up from the ground, doing this same thing, facing outward in a guardian pose.
And just staying on alert, making sure nothing pops up.
Mm-hmm.
A third one suddenly arises as a white light shines from the menhir, strikes its pose, and this just bright white light radiates from the menhir.
Back a pose.
I would say Syra would recognize that the spell has been successfully casted.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think we owe this... I think we owe this success to Karab.
Just doing my part.
Magic bros.
Magic rules!
Well, I bet they'll be glad to hear that this bane has been exorcised and this place sanctified.
I have exorcised the bane.
Bane.
So, burden being pulled back just slightly. Creatures native to the animal planet of Earth, including Earth Elementals, Labdur, gargoyles and Zorn that come in contact with Ogrémoch's bane instantly fall under the cloud's sway. The effect lasts as long as the enslaved elementals and Ogrémoch's bane are on the same plane of existence.
So the single fact that I banished it made it that's just like a cinch.
Yeah. You guys went in the right directions. Because normally I would have said, as the ruby begins to glow against the menhir, the walls begin to rumble. Part of one wall shifts, detaches, and charges towards you. But sadly, you didn't fight Earth Elementals. But I wanted you to at least see the Kalimdur.
See the fucking adorable Earth elementals.
Everybody's gushing over the cutie beauties. I got those.
Oh my god! I need to like save that hand out to my.
I will say this: they're not skishy.
Yo, they're tough old boy.
Now, Zorns, on the other hand, aren't quite as cute, but.
Save image.
And Zorns, just so you can see what Zorn looks like. Yeah, those aren't that cute. Anyways.
It still has some measure of cuteness to it, I'd say.
It's just not as fun to say. You have Zorn, and then there's Galipdur.
Galipdur. Oh, where's the Galipdur?
Even its name is Dog Derpy. It's Galipdur.
Come here, Galipdur. Come here. Isn't Zorn, like, if you give him a coin, like, a gem or something, they'll help you out? Something like that?
Let me take a look.
Because it's, like, one of the, like... Here, I know. I got the little handout. One sec.
They do like gemstones. And precious metals.
Can't. Never mind. Yeah, I'm gonna throw a little pebble at one.
Why do you hit things at rocks?
Yeah.
You're just throwing a pebble. I mean,
that's just a pebble. Creature.
Actually, yeah. Just go ahead and make me an attack roll.
Oh.
Yeah, the rules of dungeon survival, rule 6, keep a few gems in your pocket. A hungry Zorn is a helpful Zorn.
How do you want me to roll this?
It's an improvised weapon, so basically make a dexterity check.
What is he doing?
He's throwing a pebble at one
He's throwing rocks at things again. He's attacking random, innocent creatures.
The moment it leaves his hand, create bonfire on his pants.
Alright, now I want you to make a dexterity saving throw as this pebble flies through the air and clinks off one of the glebders and doesn't do anything.
I am. You know what? Three sorcery points, and that's going to be a dis... Never mind, it doesn't need to be like that, because you fail.
Alright, roll damage.
I can't believe this.
Alright, take 9 points of damage.
Pants go on fire.
No, hold on, let me see. Create bonfire. Does it say anything about, like, it actually lights anything up?
Okay. There you go.
A creature must also make the saving throw when it moves into a bonfire space for the first time.
Bonfire
ignites flammable objects on its area that aren't being worn or carried. Well, he's wearing those pants, so apparently it doesn't light it on fire.
That is just a pebble. Chill.
Since we have completed our quest early, can I hump the request we end a little early, because I have to get up early.
I was going to resolve the quest, but we can stop here and resolve it later. I'm okay with that.
Well, we can resolve it. All right. I mean, we can resolve it quick if you want to do it.
Alright, so you guys walk back to the entrance. Yeah, fast travel.
Loading screen.
Yep. We had a cutscene, and at the end of the cutscene, you ended up here.
We pressed X to skip.
No, you had an entire cutscene where Lassiter threw a pebble and Krad lighted a bonfire underneath. And then the cutscene ends with you guys walking down the stairs, and then when it when it comes back out the cutscene, here you are at the entrance, at the staging area. See here. All right. Provided me a link which didn't take me to. Here we go. All right. As you return back,
fire.
You feel the successful that you were. You report that you were successful. The priest thanks you for the service, and if you wish, I can provide a blessing to each of you. Either one of protection. Or I can enhance one of your weapons.
Well, considering my weapon is magic, I guess protection would be much applied.
Same.
Alright.
Unless you can bless my hand to cast better spells.
So basically, you would get a blessing of protection window to increase your AC by one. And also all your saving throw by one.
Nice.
Or you can get a weapon enhancement, which we'd be able to take if you do not have magical weapon already, and enhance it to a plus one.
Well, I think everybody has magic weapons that uses weapons. So I guess we're all using protection.
I don't really use that.
In this game, I use protection.
Yeah.
So we now all have a plus one to saves and AC.
Guessing if you just... Isn't there like a ring? That does that...
Yeah, but those require attunement, which is the problem.
Yeah. Because there's no way to modify... Like, for armor, that's easy, just a miscellaneous bonus. But for the...
There is a global saving throw modifier in the... If you go up to the wheel, like for the settings, at least on roll 20. I don't know if you're using D&D Beyond, but there's a way to do it there, too.
Yeah, I'm trying to see on D&D Beyond.
Okay. Yeah, global saving modifier. Plus one. And what else? AC. Let's see, just trying to move that.
Maybe make it a feat.
There we go. I am actually...
Okay.
Wait. So, might not show up at the moment, but there should now be a homebrewed item called Blessing of Protection. Wondrous item. And basically, I took a ring of protection and took off the attunement.
Blessing.
And I made the... And I made the change on roll 20 for me.
Oh. Yeah, it might take a moment for it to show up for us to add to inventory.
I got it.
Maybe next time.
You said blessing of protection?
Blessing of protection. I like just made it.
I have a 0 in my strength saving throws now.
That's a plus.
Yeah, because just boots of blood stations coming up for me right now. So, I'll check back later.
Is Syra our tank?
No.
She kind of. She's kind of dodge tank. But the tank yeah. really is Holly with
off tanking.
Close by. Yeah.
Well, I mean, at my highest, I can have an 18 or a 28 AC.
Yes.
At the moment.
As I said, you're a dodge tank. But you need to also have the certain circumstances in order to get to that.
Yeah. I consider how I would break things down is Holly is a tank. Lassiter would be support such range DPS. Syra Gage is melee DPS, where Syra can also do range DPS, and I'm straight up range DPS.
Actually, at my highest, I can have a 30 AC if I add haste to it.
I have Shield of Faith.
Blade Singer shenanigans.
Yep.
Anyway.
I should go ahead and delete the ruby from my inventory, correct?
Yes, you would. That from your inventory.
Excuse me.
All right. With that, we will end the stream. Good night, kids. Good night, listeners, watchers, whatever.